last time on Ashley.
I don't know what the status between me and Ryan is right now.
He asked me to be his Valentine.
I was like, of course.
He wrote a song for me, and he's gonna play it for me tonight.
So you were gonna sing that song for me.
Love Ryan.
And I just told Ryan he's the worst Valentine ever.
I blew it up out of proportion so bad, but we ended up making it.
I gotta just play the track for a second because I gotta.
These next couple of days are gonna be really busy for me. I have a photo shoot. I'm wrapping up my album. I have my first live performance. Hopefully, I'll be able to keep up.
I've been wanting to write a song about like being in the shadow, and I always felt like I was sort of like stuck in the shadow, but I think it'd be cool if it was like coming out of the shadow, don't you think?
Right.
Because I feel like for a while I felt like I was like stuck, you know what I mean? But I think it'd be cool to talk about not being stuck and about having like my own thing and not feeling like I'm in the shadow, you know? You think that's cool?
Not being a victim.
Exactly.
I was 6 years old.
Texas was cool. I was always a little bit of a mess.
I think a lot of second daughters are like that. A little wild.
Jessica knew from the time that she was a little girl that she wanted to be a singer.
Hallelujah to the King.
And me, I was like dancing, and that's like the emotions that I felt, and I can, you know, release them when I dance, but it wasn't exactly what I wanted to do for my career. The turn in my life was when I stepped out of dancing for my sister and found my identity.
How do I get this to work, Mom?
Baby, I've never worked it in my life, so.
Thank you, got it. God, that scared the hell out of me. Baggy dance. That's the way you
want it. It's really poppy, though. Well, there you go.
There you can. Turn it up a little bit. Now that you just let me go.
Stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Hey, Jess, they sent you this, sweetie. Rob Black did. If you want to hang this up at your place, too.
That's cute.
A bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
I like that.
Isn't that cute?
Yeah.
They made that just for you, Rolling
Stone. That's really
sweet.
Isn't
that neat?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm proud of you.
I have this photo shoot coming up, and I was over at my mom's house trying on clothes with Jess.
I don't like to be girly. I hate it.
To be girly?
Yes.
Why? Because you're a boy?
I
Actually,
what do you
are
mean?
Girly.
You
You're
are
a feminine girl.
I know, but I like to. But I like to like wear pants or like Converse tennis shoes or something to make me feel normal.
You have cute legs, though. It's like if you had like big, fat, ugly legs, I'd be like, cover them up, you know.
If you're really tan, you might feel more comfortable.
Yeah, once you tan, I think you feel better. But if you feel shy about it, then that you have such cute legs and you're so cute that, you know. But if you want to wear, I personally wouldn't do the tights.
Can you make it more boy?
Boy? You're not a boy. What do you mean?
I think that, like, a lot of times, the younger sister sometimes is, like, more just like, don't tell me what to do.
Justin and I are totally different.
Ask me.
Yo, 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 they wanna know.
It's my first photo shoot as an artist, as a musician. I'm excited.
Hi,
hey,
I'm Ashley.
I'm Alyssa. Nice,
nice to meet you.
You.
She loves you.
So much. Yay.
She loves
Thank
you.
You.
She loves you.
Crazy color.
I think I look like a clown.
You think you look like a clown?
Yeah.
Well, maybe you should just take off the fake eyelashes. I'm not the one to say I'm your mother. I'm not, you know, you should ask Allie what she thinks about it, and then I'll get... I think you should have her just take the eyelashes off.
Why does this always happen?
When does it always happen? When's the last time it happened? Please tell me. I can't control magazines, honey.
So I think that we think that we should take the eyelashes off.
Because it's going down.
We didn't curl them up yet.
Oh.
I want to let
Oh, it'll look different whenever it's curled?
Yes. We have a comb, remember?
Okay.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is something that Jessica would wear, and I don't want to wear that. Okay.
Please, let me just do a Polaroid. I'll show you. You're going to look hot and sexy.
It's
going to look off the shoulder, and I'm going to see some light coming through that thing.
Okay.
It's going to be cool. Trust me.
Yeah. Give it a chance.
Can you do it up there?
And then if not, we'll...
Or do you need to do it down
go
there?
Go from there.
No.
Okay? Because he's got, like, some concept going on in his head.
I know, but you know what I'm saying.
Okay.
I'm very weird about this guy.
She doesn't want anything that resembles anything that Jessica would ever do.
You understand where I'm coming from, though, right? That, like, I have a specific thing that they
no,
asked
totally.
Me to do.
No, totally. I don't want you to, like, be upset with me either, because,
no,
like, you have to understand where
you.
I'm coming from.
I don't
want to
start by having a bad reputation, because there's going to be a lot of magazines you want to be in, and one thing you've learned is that it's a small family. Stop pouting already.
You don't like it? We don't wear it, sweetheart.
Granny, you look hot in your old shawl. Beautiful.
Okay, you did it.
It's time to go home, kid.
That didn't go in too painful.
Mm-hmm.
1:30.
Perfect.
Very good. No way. Over 7,000 people are at her in-store right now.
Oh, my God.
In Walmart, in Boston.
When the photo shoot was done, my mom gets a phone call from my sister, and she was freaking out. She was like, Mom, there's like 7,000 fans here. And she said, you know, she's never experienced it. She was like, whoa, this is crazy. It was like one of those feelings for her and for my mom, like, wow. Like, she's really like a big star now.
I miss you so much. I watched your all your shows, David Letterman and Good Morning and all that stuff, and you looked gorgeous.
I definitely hope one day that I can, you know, attain that level of success.
Well, I love you. Here's Mom. Okay, bye. So we finally got to the process of putting my band together. So I'm really excited because I'm going to go in there and check out some of the guys and see what I think about them. And my best friend Ray is putting them together.
Thanks, guys.
give us a wait outside for like 5-10 minutes. Give us some time. You're fine. I like Braxton.
I like Braxton too. I think he's cute.
And I like Zach.
I like Zach too. I think they have a good chemistry.
Yeah, they work well together, and they're both young. They're both young. They both got a good look.
Okay. All right, so them three.
Yeah.
They're my favorite.
Cool.
Today is my last day in the studio to put final touches on my album. We're putting strings on Shadow, and I think it'll bring a cool life to the songs. You know, it's going to be amazing with strings, I think.
Hi, I'm Ashley. Thank you guys so much for coming
out. We're just going to move the mics out a little bit.
I need to get my bangs cut. But maybe it's time for something new. But now that I'm done, I can do whatever I want to my hair. What are you gonna wear?
I don't know what he's gonna wear.
I think I'm gonna wear those the Rachel Pally pants. I think that's what I wanna wear. With like a big poofy dress.
See, strings. Look.
Like a prom dress.
How expensive this moment is for you.
Decided to dye my hair because I just needed to do something new, and I kind of like wanted to do something spontaneous and kind of shock everybody, and I definitely think that I did that. I didn't do it to separate myself from my sister, but it's a lot of fun because she's got this like platinum blonde hair and I've got this like really dark hair, and it's cool because now when we like hang out and everything, it totally has, you know, made us completely different, and I like that. I'm here for my first day of band rehearsal. I'm really excited because I finally get to sing my songs live. So I'm excited to hear the band playing it and nervous because I hope that, you know, it sounds good live. I got bored the other day and decided to dye it dark. Something different. How are y'all?
Good. Wanna just try it?
Get lighter. I don't really care about that. I hear you sing.
Shut up. Come back. No, I didn't really mean to say that. I messed up. So what? Yeah, you want me, so you messed up too. I love you. I hate you. If you only know what I've been through. I'm a nasty girl in this crazy world.
Okay, that sucked really bad.
Yeah,
that's
horrible.
Yeah. Is it too low for me right there?
It's like a man.
I don't know.
You're singing the harmony.
Did the other one sound as bad?
No. Did that sound weird just then? It's so high for me. Like whenever I recorded it, I only recorded it like 2 times.
I think it sounds like you're pushing too hard. I don't think you should.
I know, but like.
You're sharp, which means you're pushing hard.
Yeah.
I sound horrible.
Yeah. No, but it's not, you're not. Sharp is better than flat.
Right.
Sharp means you're overshooting.
Yeah.
Flat means you can't hit it.
Right.
So just calm back a little. It's just you're singing it too hard. It's
okay. That was so bad.
Everybody judges theirself way too hard.
The very first day of band rehearsal sucked. I couldn't hear myself. I sounded horrible. I was having problems with my voice.
it was just a complete nightmare. In all honesty, I was scared to death after that rehearsal. I was like, is this how it's gonna be like when I perform? Am I gonna be able to perform? That one sucked. It was just a nightmare, a complete nightmare. We are here at rehearsal again, and today Eric Vitro, my voice coach, is coming in, and he's just gonna help me with the songs and just make sure that, you know, there's no bad notes or anything, and I'm just gonna hit all this stuff again with the guys before he gets here.
I found myself wrong again, staring out my window, wondering what it is I should have said. I found myself at home again, waiting for the after call from a fallout that feels like such a mess. My voice is gone.
I'm really just tired.
Do you want to wait till your guy gets here?
No, we can do like two more and then.
It's probably just like, even though you're resting, it's probably just a lot of strain, you know?
Yeah.
It's from, you're not used to doing a couple hours a day every day?
Yeah.
You gotta build up your vocal cords.
Hey, Dad, it's me. I was just calling you. I don't really have a voice, so I'm just calling you to see what I was supposed to do. All right, bye.
How are you?
Here.
I know.
It's good to see you.
How's it going?
So I just lost my voice. I think it's because I've been like, tired and like going, and then I think I might be singing like for a lot from here.
Probably.
All right, so stand back and slightly bend your knees. Good, take a deep breath in and then exhale. Bebo, 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 bebo.
Bebo, 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 bebo.
Yeah, exactly. Good, take a deep breath.
Nay, 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 nay.
I almost think this is probably enough warm-up right now.
It seems like I can finally rest my head on something real.
I sound horrible.
Yeah, I'm afraid if you keep doing it, it's just going to make it worse right
now. Yeah.
Could you actually be silent? Is there such a thing as you being silent tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday?
I can try.
Because if you were really, really quiet, if you went to see the doctor tomorrow, and then you were really, really quiet Friday, Saturday, Sunday, then Monday we could start again. But this weekend, don't go to any loud clubs. Don't talk over loud music.
Okay.
Don't talk. We gotta free you up from that tension. Why are you so tense?
I don't know. Isn't that horrible?
I know. You're so tense.
I think I have so much stress.
You're such a young girl.
I'm all stressed out for like no reason. I don't know why.
All right, I'll talk to you later.
Okay, cool. Bye.
Bye. Go be quiet.
Okay, I will. What are you doing? Okay, well, I'm at the doctor right now, and I don't think that I'm going to be able to sing today.
Okay, no worries.
So, we're not going to have practice today, and I don't enjoy that I'm supposed to sing tomorrow either.
Okay.
So,
we are ready?
Yes, we are. Hey, the doctor just walked in, so let me call you whenever I'm done. I'm Ashley, and I just finished my album, and now I'm like working, like I'm rehearsing and stuff for tour, but I've been kind of getting sick and my glands, like it's like all swollen.
Have you been clenching your teeth a little bit at nighttime while you're sleeping?
Probably.
Okay, we have to get you to mellow out a little bit.
That is such a good idea.
Tilt your head back. I'm just gonna get a swab of your throat. It looks like you might be developing a little something on your vocal cord.
That's scary. They're gonna have to like cancel my show and everything. I'm stressed out right now.
Just breathe through your nose, record.
There they are.
Say. We have to talk.
Yes.
Not only do you have reflux, you've got severe reflux. Now, For anybody, it would create problems, but for a singer, the impact is huge.
I was seriously depressed. I was like, oh my gosh, I don't think I could perform. And I almost felt like I was gonna lose all confidence, like in myself. I was just really bummed. To be continued on Ashley.
I'm going to the voice doctor for my checkup.
I didn't want to find out something bad about my voice. Today is my very first show. So what's my damage? I can't hear myself. I was under a little bit of stress. That sound check was not very good. All this like buildup and everybody was like, no, is she gonna do bad? At that point, I didn't know what I was doing. I couldn't hear anything. It was awful.